Hello and welcome everyone back to the channel ASV476. I request you all to subscribe to my channel because very soon I am going to upload videos on 11th and 12th physics and chemistry and as well as engineering physics and chemistry. So today's topic which we are going to learn is nothing but the Fermi level. Fermi level is that level which gives us the probability of finding a majority charge carrier. Now we will understand it in a better way when we take the examples. So now first we will see the Fermi level in an intrinsic semiconductor. So this is our valence band. This is the conduction band. Now we all know that electrons from here go into the conduction band and a hole is created over here. Now in an intrinsic semiconductor, the number of holes created will be equal to the number of electrons passed into the conduction band. So suppose if there are 20 holes created, which means that 20 electrons are excited into the conduction band. So the number of holes and number of electrons is equal. So the number of electrons is equal to the number of holes. So if there is a minus 20 on the upper side, there's a positive 20 on the lower side. So since there is equality in the charge carriers, therefore the Fermi level will lie exactly in between the conduction band and valence band. Now we will see for a p-type semiconductor. Now as we all know that in a p-type semiconductor, the majority charge carriers are the holes, and holes are present in this valence band. And since that after adding the trivalent impurity we get holes in this valence band, therefore there is more positive charge in the valence band as compared to the conduction band. In conduction band there are very less number of electrons, and due to the addition of impurity, trivalent impurity, we get more charge in this valence band. So positive charge is more in this valence band, and the charge carriers in the p-type semiconductor are holes. Therefore the Fermi level will be nearer to the valence band. Now let us consider a n-type semiconductor. Now you all can predict what's the answer. See, this is the valence band, this is the conduction band, and we all know that in the n-type semiconductors there are electrons which are excited from the valence band. But since the number of excited electrons is greater in the conduction band, therefore the Fermi level will lie nearer to the conduction band, because in n-type semiconductor the majority charge carriers are electrons, and electrons are mostly found in more in the conduction band. So the probability of finding a charge is more in the conduction band. Therefore the Fermi level will lie towards the conduction band. So this is all we should know about the basis of the Fermi level, p-type and n-type. The changes due to the change in temperature and change in concentration, how it will affect the Fermi level, we will be doing it in the next video. So please subscribe to my channel. As soon as I upload the video, you all will be getting a notification of it. I will be uploading all the videos of 11th and 12th soon, as well as engineering first year. Thank you.